We're going behind the headlines now in some of today's top political stories. And as many of you know, Republican U.S. Senate candidate Terrence Wall dropped out last week, virtually clearing the field for Ron Johnson. He still has Dave Westlake to contend with. But was Terrence Wall's candidacy doomed almost from the start? We're asking J.R. Ross of WisPolitics.com. J.R., thanks very much for being with us today. Let's talk a little bit about what happened last week. I mean, you can understand why Dick Leinenkugel would get out of the race. The reaction he got from his own party was not very welcoming. But Terrence Wall had been out doing the work. He had been to all the dinners around the state trying to convince people he was the guy. He was trying to get endorsements. He had spent some of his own money. And he even said he had proven that he could win, but then he decides to get out. Why?
Two things, really. One, Ron Johnson can write a bigger check, and two, Ron Johnson doesn't have the baggage that Terrence Wall does. I mean, you know, Terrence got out there first. He's put at least, you know, $1.5 million of his own money in this race, but he's been really plagued by these questions about his personal tax bill from almost the get-go. And, you know, there's nothing wrong when you talk to people, you know, operators will say, look, there's nothing wrong with a guy going out and trying to lower his taxes as much as possible. We all try and do it at tax time. But when you're running for office and you're worth $50, $60, $70 million at least, and you've paid almost nothing in taxes in the last decade, I mean, that's a tough question to answer in a time when people are hurting, they're upset about government, about insiders, about people who are, you know, kind of gaming the system. How do you answer that question? And he never got a good answer to that question about why have you not paid more in taxes?
And the fear, you know, wasn't the fear, JR, within the party that those revelations, and again, apparently all legal, but those revelations so soon after he announced essentially doomed his candidacy. The Republican Party could see ad after ad being run by the Feingold campaign saying, hey, did you know Terrence Wall didn't pay state income taxes 12 out of 15 years?
Absolutely. And then just when the story started to die down, the Tommy Thompson talk kind of ramped up. And while Tommy was talking about running, now here's Terrence out there trying to build a campaign and raise money, and he can't get any traction because Tommy Thompson is sucking all the oxygen out of the room. So it really kind of was a double whammy for him that, one, there's a tax problem, and two, there's a Tommy Thompson problem.
Quick final question. Republicans had a pretty successful convention in Milwaukee. They really had a very energetic group of folks there, more than they had originally anticipated. What did Democrats have to do at their upcoming convention to energize their base?
You know, there could be a couple of things here. One, you know, Ron Johnson could actually be good for Democrats in some ways when you talk to them, because he could pose a real threat to Russ Feingold. I mean, Johnson has been on this meteoric rise, to say the least. Mm-hmm. If he's a real threat, that energizes people because all of a sudden they're scared. I mean, what's going to happen to Russ? Russ Feingold is well loved by Democrats. If they see a threat to Russ, they could get energized. Also, remember, Wisconsin is in some ways very much a little bit of a Democratic-leaning state. So what they might lose a little bit in a bad year, maybe they can make up for an organization and infrastructure. And if they can get people out, you know, activate the base in some ways, that could help. So really it's a matter of getting them inspired, getting that feeling of, hey, we've got to defend one of our own kind of thing, and maybe that can help them catch up a little bit. But right now, there's no question that Republicans have momentum on their side.
All right. J.R. Ross from WisPolitics.com. Always appreciate you being with us. Thanks very much.
No problem, Mike.
The Democratic candidate for governor, Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett, has started running his first television ad of the campaign. The 60-second ad says Barrett is the only candidate in the governor's race with a record of bringing jobs to Wisconsin.
One candidate for governor has a record of bringing jobs to Wisconsin, Tom Barrett. As Milwaukee's mayor, Tom Barrett helped bring government and business leaders together from urban, suburban, and rural counties to create jobs. The results.
WisPolitics.com reports the ad is being seen in Green Bay, La Crosse, and Wausau. Barrett's Republican opponents have been running TV ads for several months. Coming up next on Upfront, what Google means to Wisconsin.